Mr. Nitish Tiwari, he's the writer and director of our film Dangal. This is Fatima, she's one of the actresses in the film. Unfortunately, the other girl, Sania, she's a little unwell, so she couldn't come down. She's just recovering. So it's a film that we've made with a lot of love and care, and something that we are very happy with. And we are happy to answer any questions that you might have about the film. Thank you.
Every time you're coming with different concepts, and with the social concepts is always there in your movies. So we can see how you select your scripts, how you get these kind of scripts.
Well, first I must say that these concepts are not mine. It is the writers who come up with the story ideas and they write the script. So it is my good fortune that I get these scripts which are written by such wonderful writers, and they come my way, and I'm happy to be a part of them. In this case, Nitish sir and his team have written the script. How I choose a script is actually very simple. I listen to the narration of the script, and if it excites me, if it touches me, moves me, and you know, it just attracts me, that when I'm listening to the script, I'm like an audience watching a film. So if I love it, then I want to be a part of it, and it's a decision I take immediately then and there when I hear the script. If I love it, I want to be a part of it.
Is coming in Tamil and Telugu this time.
Yes, we are dubbing it in
so
Tamil.
Have you seen your Tamil and Telugu version of the movie? You're speaking in Telugu. How was your experience
that? I've not seen the whole film yet because I was so busy in the post-production of the Hindi version also. But we have seen the trailers, the shorter versions with the trailers we have seen, and
also a few scenes dubbed in Tamil.
A few scenes that we've seen, so I quite like that, watching myself speaking Tamil and Telugu. It was really nice.
So are you ready for the Telugu industry now, we can say?
Well, I wish I could have, done a film in the original language itself, but it'll be a little difficult for me to learn an entirely new language. But if that happens, I would love it.
One line in Telugu, I mean, about your movie,
I don't know how to speak Telugu. I'm so sorry. Yeah. I'm so sorry. That depends on the script, you know. And my co-stars are not selected by me, they're selected by my director.
No, your choice, sir. You love to act with someone in a South Indian movie.
Well, I think if it's a Telugu film, I've always been a big fan of Mr. Chiranjeevi.
Wow.
And Mr. Pavan Kalyan. So, you know, I would love to act with them. I would. If it's a Tamil film, I would love to work with Mr. Rajnikanth. He's someone who I've been a huge fan of all along. So if I get the chance to work with him, I would love that.
Sir, you have put on so much weight and then reduced. So it was the toughest period. I have seen your video of you doing gym and all. So how was your feeling, sir, putting on so much weight?
Well, it was tough. Because even putting on the weight, I had to put it on very quickly. In 4 to 5 months, I had to put on that weight. And then I had to lose it in 5 months also. So it was a very difficult thing. Physically, it was very taxing for me. But I'm happy that it happened. Yeah, my wife Kiran and my mother, they were very upset with me that I was playing with my health like that. And, you know, putting on weight so fast, reducing it so fast. They were very concerned. But I managed to, convince them lovingly.
Sir, yeah. Sir, सबसे पहले तो मैं सल्यूट करूँगा आपकी टीम को.
हाँ जी, thank you.
कि आपने इतना बेहतरीन, wonderful subject उठाया है.
जी, शुक्रिया.
दिव्या राव, नितेश तिवारी जी.
जी, जी.
आमिर खान साहब.
शुक्रिया.
सिद्धार्थ राय कपूर. कि हमारे मुल्क में लड़कियों के साथ इम्तियाजी सुलूक जारी है सर.
जी जी.
उसके ऊपर जो ये फिल्म बनी है
जी,
यकीनन सारे मुल्क के अलावा तमाम सारी दुनिया में पसंद की जाएगी.
शुक्रिया.
मेरे हिसाब से
शुक्रिया.
और मध्य प्रदेश में टैक्स फ्री किया गया है इसके ऊपर.
मेरे ख्याल है मैंने यूपी का अनाउंसमेंट सुना है, यूपी में टैक्स फ्री हो गई. अच्छा, मध्य प्रदेश में भी हो गई.
अच्छा, यूपी का. हाँ, तो सारे मुल्क में भी कुछ ऐसे चांसेस है सर?
हाँ, हमारी जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टीम है डिज्नी की, उसने सारे स्टेट्स में अप्लाई किया है टैक्स एग्जेम्पशन के लिए, क्योंकि हमें लगता है कि ये फिल्म जो है वो ऑडियंस तक ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा पहुँचे, और जब फिल्म टैक्स फ्री होती है तो उसका टिकट रेट भी कम हो जाता है, तो लोगों के लिए आसानी हो जाती है फिल्म देखने के लिए. तो हम चाहते हैं कि ये जो फिल्म बनी है वो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोग देख पाएँ, इसलिए हमने टैक्स एग्जेम्पशन के लिए अप्लाई किया।
सर आपसे दूसरा सवाल ये है कि पीके के ठीक बाद आपने इसकी शूटिंग शुरू की थी।
जी जी,
आप ऑलरेडी पर्सनालिटी बनाए हुए थे
जी,
तो आपने स्टार्ट क्यों नहीं किया बाद में?
मतलब पहले मैंने मोटे का शूटिंग किया, मोटेपन का, फिर उसकी वजह यह है कि अगर मैंने, आप सही कह रहे हैं, पीके में मेरे जो बॉडी थी अच्छी थी, वो 9% बॉडी फैट था जो हमें चाहिए था, और सर ने मुझे बताया भी कि हम मुस्ती से शुरू करते हैं, आप तो तैयार हैं उसके लिए, यंग पार्ट के लिए। लेकिन मेरा ये कहना था नितीश सर से कि अगर मैं पहले यंग पार्ट कर लूँ फिर बाद में जो ओल्डर पार्ट है मैं वो करूँ जब मुझे मोटा होना है, तो जब शूटिंग मुकम्मल होगी, कंप्लीट होगी, तो उस वक्त मैं 97 किलोस का रहूँगा, बहुत ही मोटा रहूँगा, और वज़न कम करने की कोई वजह नहीं होगी मेरे पास। तो बेहतर ये है कि मैं पहले मोटा हो जाऊँ और जब वो शूटिंग पूरी हो जाए, जो 90% फिल्म जो है वो उसमें मैं मोटा हूँ, तो वो जब शूटिंग कंप्लीट हो जाए फिर मैं वज़न दोबारा कम करके जो बाकी 10% है वो मैं लास्ट में करूँ, ताकि जब शूटिंग कंप्लीट हो मैं जहाँ से शुरू हुआ था मैं वहीं पर आके रुकूँ।
Are you think this is going to be the next Tare Zameen Par or your Three Idiots with a social message?
Well, I mean, I hope it is as loved by people as these two films were. We have, I think, Nitish sir and his team of three other writers have written a beautiful script. And when we see the film today, I feel that what Nitish sir has narrated to us, he has managed to bring that out on screen very beautifully. So we're very happy with the film and we hope that people love the film. We hope that, films like Tare Zameen Par or Three Idiots had a very wonderful response. The people really loved the film. And we are hoping that in Dangal also people really love the film.
Are you a real Hanikarak Bapu in your real life?
No, I think I'm not. I'm quite the opposite. I'm a father who's very loving and I'm not a hard father at all.
Can we expect more pictures like this?
More?
Can we expect more pictures like this? More films like this?
More films like this.
In future?
Yeah, I hope so.
Bhutnath ke baad Raju Hirani jaisa subject liye hai. Raju Hirani jaisa subject liye hai. Is baare mein aap kya bolenge?
Darasal, wo actually maine bataya logon ko.
Okay.
Uski wajah ye hai ki Raju Hirani ki ek khaas baat hai. Wo jo subject uthate hain wo bahut hi गहरा और मीनिंगफुल और बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक्स उठाते हैं राजू जी, लेकिन जो वो कहानी बताते हैं आपको उसमें वो बड़ा एंटरटेन करके बताते हैं, आपको हंसाते हैं, आपको देखने वक्त मज़ा आता है, तो जो कहानी का जो बताने का तरीका है उसमें एक मज़ेदार तरीका है, ह्यूमर के साथ खेलते हैं। तो मुझे लगा था इस दफ़ा आपने भी ऐसे ही किया सर, जो आप कह रहे हैं वो बहुत ही गहरी बात है, बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट बात है, लेकिन आपका जो अंदाज़ है कहने का उसमें बहुत ह्यूमर है और मजाक है।
सर मैं तो खुद ही राजू सर का बहुत बड़ा फ़ैन हूँ, तो मैं आई विल टेक इट एज अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट अगर लोगों को फिल्म देख कर लगता है कि मैंने कुछ उनकी तरह अचीव किया है, तो इट विल बी अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट फॉर मी। ऑन स्क्रीन आई वुड से यस, बट इन रियल लाइफ आई विल हैव वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग डाउट्स, बिकॉज इफ यू लुक एट what our girls go through, not these girls but the girls who represent India in wrestling, they start at a very early age, and by the time they reach or by the time these girls like Sakshi, Vinesh, Babita and Geeta, they've all represented India in Olympics, so by the time they reach that level they have spent close to 12 to 13 years in training themselves in wrestling, so that's like dedication to the max. You know, these girls have trained just for a year and they have trained to be good enough to look like an accomplished wrestler on screen, you know, but those girls have reached some other level, you know, so yeah, on screen
but
I think
the
they
film
can find.
You will not tell the difference in the film, you will feel that they're Olympic level wrestlers.
In the film they have actually fought the real wrestlers, there is not even an actor, there is not even a single actor who they are fighting. In fact, one of our match is against a girl who's got Commonwealth silver and she lost to Babita in Glasgow. But in the film, she's fighting with Geeta. So
they fought very world-class level wrestlers and not a single shot in the film in the wrestling is with a duplicate. Not a single, everything they have done.
Not tough it was for you?
It was very tough because I don't come from a sports background. So जब ये पहली बार wrestling हुई, we had to do it for three just in the audition. So we had to wrestle for 3 hours and then go do gym for an hour. And if you're not used to it, no, Baba, your body doesn't, matlab, you can't get up only in the morning. You can't walk. And I used to live on the third floor. So no lift. So after workout and after wrestling, whenever I used to go back home, I used to just cry. How can I climb these three floors? But it's very difficult. But because of our coach, Kripa Shankar, sir, he made our wrestling so much fun. And he's quite a entertaining coach. So I think it's because all the credit goes to him.
And one thing, you know, she's trying to be a bit modest here. You know, I have seen these girls struggle. I have seen all four of them struggle. You know, when they got started, you know, they were nowhere close to what we had visioned in our head. But because our trainer told, you know, that these girls can achieve in 6 to 8 months time, you know, we kind of trusted in these girls. From sacrificing their personal life to bulking up, which is not an easy thing for a girl to do. You know, why would a girl want to bulk up? You know, but they did it for their role. I have seen these girls go through injuries. You know, she's broken her ribs. She's fractured her ankle. She's got muscle tear. They have, in fact, Amir sir has also gone through all those problems. But despite of all that, you know, they never said no. You know, they were always there. They didn't let us know for quite some time. Because they were worried that the shooting might come to a standstill or the preparations might come to a standstill. So quite a lot of effort which has gone from these girls also.
मुझे 4 महीने लगे. Wrestling तो मेरी करीबन 8 महीना चली shooting से पहले हम सब की. और shooting के दौरान भी हम करते थे wrestling. तो wrestling लगभग 1 साल 1.5 साल हम लोग wrestling हमने किया. और हरियाणवी की जो प्रैक्टिस थी वो हमने 4 महीना शूटिंग से पहले 4 महीना फिर शूटिंग के दौरान भी हम लोग रिहर्सल करते रहते थे. हाँ इंजरीज भी हुई मुझे क्योंकि शूटिंग के दौरान एक दो फाइट्स में मुझे इंजरीज भी हुई लेकिन वो तो इट्स पार्ट ऑफ द गेम.
हाय
हमारे जो कोच है ना कृपा जी वो नेशनल लेवल कोच हैं जो हमारे साथ रहे तो वो उन्होंने उनका एक बहुत अच्छा लाइन था कि इंजरी जो होती है वो पहलवान का गहना होता है.
हाय
वेल इफ यू रीड द कैच लाइन मारी छोरियां छोरों से कम है के दैट इज इन इज द हार्ट ऑफ द फिल्म इज ट्राइंग टू से दैट देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ गर्ल एंड अ बॉय
टू मेन सो डू यू थिंक आई थिंक वी आर एट द कस्प ऑफ डूइंग समथिंग ग्रेट एज फार एज वुमेन इन स्पोर्ट्स इज कंसर्न एंड डू यू थिंक अ फिल्म लाइक दंगल would go a long way in inspiring more women to take up even sports like wrestling and fencing, you know, these kind of sports.
Yeah, I hope so. I think Nitish ji also feels the same. We hope that, you know, a film like Dangal will contribute to that. And it will encourage a lot of young girls to enter the arena of sports, not only in wrestling, but even in other sports. We hope that that happens. And it's wonderful to see, as you were saying, it's wonderful to see that women sports persons are doing so well and, you know, are making us very proud. Yeah, she's very fond of football.
Yes.
So she's played football for a number of years now and that has been her favorite game. So she's always been into sports. I mean and she's played some tournaments, she's played for a school, she's played for a college also. So she's been quite an enthusiast in sports also. Yeah.
Do we see Aira working with you in any of the films in future?
I would love that. I would hope so because you know films is my passion. And if my children decide to come in the films, it'll be a very happy moment for me. I love badminton. I love tennis, squash, cricket, football.
What is left?
Hockey. I love all the games. I love playing all the games. And I've played all the games, you know, on school level, college level. So I love sports. Yeah. Sashi ji, darasal, bahut hi kamal ki actor hai. और जब हमने स्क्रीन टेस्ट किया उनके साथ तो हमको सबको इतना पसंद आया और फिल्म के अंदर जब आप देखेंगे फिल्म आप महसूस करेंगे कि इतना सेंसिटिव परफॉर्मेंस दिया है साक्षी जी ने बहुत ही कमाल की आर्टिस्ट है वो सीक्रेट सुपरस्टार.
या सो इन दैट आल्सो यू आर एक्टिंग राइट?
या आई एम एक्टिंग इन दैट.
Okay, so before the release of Dangal, you have released that teaser.
Yeah,
so
because you know everyone complains to me.
Okay.
They say that your film comes after 2 years and all 3 years. So I thought I must address that complaint.
Okay.
So now within 8 months, you will see my next film.
So okay. In a year, how many movies you'll be doing? Because in a year, we see you once.
Yeah, one.
Like Shah Rukh sir has promised that in a year, he'll come 3 times. So you'll be...
I can't make promises because I don't... You know, it depends on my creative instincts and I can't make a promise. But I'll try to do as much as I can. It takes me time to do one film. At least 1 year. Sometimes it takes... Dangal took us 2 years. So, we can't commit.
Sir, how was it working with 4 girls?
Oh, it was wonderful. Yeah. It was absolutely wonderful. These 4 girls, today there is only one of them here. But all the 4 girls are outstanding. They come with such an amazing energy. They are so talented. They're so hardworking, so committed. It was a joy to work with them. And I think the energy that they brought to the set, the vibe, was wonderful. I really enjoyed working with them. I learned so much from them. That I don't know, but I've learned a lot from them. We'll ask her that. But before that, let me tell you, when I see the film today, I feel that I've been working for, you know, 27 years now. When I see them, I feel they are at least 10 steps ahead of me. As actors and, you know, as creative people. So it's wonderful to see the youth, you know, coming with such an amazing energy. Yeah, I feel very happy.
And so off the camera also, you've been treating them like daughters. Only wo feel rehta tha because it was continuous.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, we used to spend a lot of time together. Even when we were training and getting ready, I'll tell you, we used to spend a lot of time together. We used to go for wrestling training in the morning for 2 hours, 3 hours.
So automatic dad will come. Huh?
Then we used to sit, we used to go through the Haryanvi training, we used to do that together. Then we used to go for weight training together into the gym. Then in the middle, we used to play games, Catan. There's a wonderful board game called Settlers of Catan, which I'm the champion of. So we used to play different kinds of games and all that. So we spent a lot of, we were like a family together. Yeah.
You remember?
Yeah.
So I was just sitting and you playing that game Catan that he's talking about. And he just comes in and he says that he has a cup in his hand. And he just mentions, yaar, kitna garam coffee diya aaj. Kitna garam hai. And khali ek do baar bola. So it's like, I know it's hot. And just, he's standing right in front of me and he drops the cup. And I'm like, I jump out of my skin and it's empty. So it has a string attached and that's how he always keeps surprising us.
So what do you learn from Amir sir?
Actually, a lot because, you know, everybody knows that he's very passionate about his work. And just to see him act and just to see him working on his character is quite, it's, I don't know what to say. It's you learn a lot because that makes me work harder. Because he's working so hard, he's been working since so many years, you know. He's been in this industry since so many years. And yet, every time he goes into a character, he just goes for it. Like, even in this film, he put on weight, he lost weight, he's just...
Shah Rukh is a favorite.
Yeah, that's what I was asking.
In front of me, she's not saying it. But you can say, I'm also a fan of his, don't worry.
Shah Rukh Khan.
So we want to know about your look of the day. As we can see, you're loving your moochas, I'm watching that. So
oh, yeah,
what's
my
look of the day?
Well, this is, you know, there's a film I'm starting in month of March. It's called Thugs of Hindustan. It is being produced by Adi Chopra, directed by Victor Vijayacharya, and there's Mr. Bachchan and me in the film. So it's a period film, so which is why I'm growing my beard. We have not locked the final look yet. That we will do only in the month of Feb. But in the meantime, I'm just growing my beard and my hair.
And Amir, I just want to ask you, in every movie, you have one special look. So what is behind that? Like...
Well, it really depends on the character I'm playing. So, depending on what the character is, I try and appear like that physically also. Yeah. Ji.
Amir Khan always behind records. So, this time you are coming after demonetization. Yeah. So, people are all in at ATM queues. Hmm. What are your expectations on collections?
You know, I don't ever think of collections when I'm doing a film. Because that is not the reason why I'm doing the film. For me, I love the story and I want to be a part of it. And I want to touch people's hearts. I want them to love the film. So I feel that for me, the biggest thing will be if people see my film and love it. It doesn't matter if for, you know, some, for whatever reasons, if some people are not able to see, I understand. But I would love for them to love the film. How much collection the film does is secondary for me. How much they love the film, that is more important.
No, I think the book has just come. The movie, I'll tell you what, you know, I started working on Dangal 4 years back. I met Geeta Babita, Mahavir Singh Ji, his wife, the coaches, the cousins and the villagers 4 years back. You know, that's when the seed was sown. And after 4 years of starting the process, the film is going to get released.
Nitesh sir, as we can see, you know, biopic area has come. You know, people are getting into the biopic cinema. So what's your take on personally, because this will also be on biopic. So what's your take on that?
I don't follow trends personally. You know, as I said, you know, we started working on Dangal 4 years back. There was no trend back then. You know, so it became a trend in between, you know. But that's with every industry, you know. Any product which becomes successful, you will see many such followers which will come up, you know. So, it depends, you know, whether there are more success stories or there are less success stories, but it doesn't bother me, nor do I follow a trend as such.
Any other you're following up that you, in future you would like to go for any biopic or any character actually inspire you the most that in the future you would go for that? Is anything happening?
I have not really thought about it. Dangal has kept me very busy. I have given 100% to Dangal. So, I have not really thought beyond Dangal yet. So, maybe once the euphoria and the excitement settles down, maybe I'll be able to calm myself down and think about the future.
Sir, your epic transformation for this particular film has also attracted criticism from fitness experts that it's at your age, it's not so easy to gain weight and lose that excess weight as well. So, you have any comments for that?
Yeah, it's not easy. I agree. It's very difficult.
But they are also kind of accusing you of using substances which might be harmful.
No, I've not used any substances. And I think that the average, a good rate to lose weight is roughly 1 pound a week. That is considered a very good rate to lose weight. If you want to lose weight a little faster, then you have a more of a calorie deficit. So, if you have a calorie deficit of 500 calories a day, you lose 1 pound a week. If you have a calorie deficit of 1,000 calories a day, you lose 2 pounds a week. That is considered to be on the higher side. When I started the weight loss process, I was doing double of that. I was losing 2 kilos, which is about 4 pounds. 4 pounds a week I was losing for the first 3 weeks. And then I brought it down to 2 pounds a week. So, I had 20 weeks to do that. So, if you do the math, you'll understand that that is how I got to where I got to.
So, in comparison,
so I have not used substances.
Yeah, of course. I believe that because your body has been, you have been working out since Ghulam.
Yeah.
Pretty honestly.
Not only that, what I think what some people don't realize is that they feel that after the fat portion, I started to lose weight and started to work out. But the truth is that after the fat portion, I started to lose weight. But my workout was going on from 2 years before that. So even when I was fat, I was doing very heavy weight training. You could not see the muscles because they were covered in a big, thick layer of fat. So you could not see that muscle. But the reason you could not see the muscle is because you see the muscle when the fat melts and you see the shape of the muscle. But you could not see the shape because there was so much fat. But my weight training, my muscle building, what we speak about, was going on not for 5 months. It was going on for 2 years. Yeah. Immediately after PK, I was continuing in that weight training mode for 2 years. And only in those last 5 months, along with the weight training, I went on to a diet. So that cut the fat, if you know what I'm trying to say.
And so you know, would you say Gajni was tougher or Dangal?
No, this was tougher. this was tougher because putting on weight in such a short time and, you know, trying to lose all the fat in such a short time was very tough. Yeah.
All the success to you, sir. 800 crores for Dangal.
Thank you.
And so we have seen every time a new look, a new language also. Like in PK, we saw your...
Yeah, in PK, I was speaking Bhojpuri.
Bhojpuri. Yeah. Here, you're speaking Haryanvi.
Yeah.
So, any other language you wanted ke next movie mein, I would like to experiment? Or you feel like hearing it and speaking it?
Well, you know, it really depends on the character and the role. I mean, I don't pre-decide what, what dialect I'm going to use. In a sense, I'm speaking in Hindustani. So, Bhojpuri is very close to Hindustani and, you know... In fact, Hindi and Urdu have come from Bhojpuri in a sense. Bhojpuri is an older language than Hindi also. And Haryanvi again is a dialect that we use. So if you speak Hindi or understand Hindi, you will understand Haryanvi also. Because we have kept it to be quite an easy version of Haryanvi. We have not gone very strong, which ko gaada ha bolte na, very thick Haryanvi we have not gone. Because otherwise people won't understand what we are saying. So we've kept a slightly simple form of Haryanvi where you get the flavor also. Plus, you understand what we are saying. So, it really depends on what character I'm playing. Then
but sir, if you get a good script from South, will you ready to learn Tamil, Telugu, or Kannada? will you take that challenge?
If I get a wonderful script from South, like in a language I don't speak at all, Tamil, Telugu, or Malayalam, or Kannada, if it's a really beautiful script and a role, I would take the challenge. I would love to... I may not be able to learn the language because that takes longer, but I can definitely learn the dialogues that I have in the film with the correct phonetics, because ultimately it's all about phonetics. So if you can memorize the lines phonetically correct, then you can then you can do the film in that language. So if the role is if the script is really wonderful, I would definitely take up the challenge. Personal experience of putting on weight was very uncomfortable. I was not used to it. So suddenly, because normally, you know, when people put on weight, they put it on gradually. Over the years, you put on weight. I put on the weight in, you know, between 4 and 6 months, I had put on the 27 kilos. So all of a sudden, I was much fatter, much heavier. And it certainly affected me in many ways. I was not used to it. My breathing had changed. I could not bend to tie my shoelace because my stomach would come in the way. No, I would only tie it. But after tying one shoe, I had to stop. I would breathe like that. Then I would go to the next one.
Sir, have you got any warnings from Kiran ma'am? No changes Kiran, in weight like this.
You see, yeah, Kiran ma'am and my mom and my doctor also has told me you cannot do this again and again. Kiran ma'am has also made one more complaint. She has said that every time you're doing a new film, you have a new... look. So I have forgotten how you originally look. Every year, there is a dip because when I met her first time, I was doing Mangal Pandey. So Mangal Pandey, I was looking totally different. Actually, when I met her, it was a little after Dil Chahta Hai. So, but I had not yet signed Mangal Pandey that time. So it was that kind of look. Then I did Mangal Pandey. Then I did Rang De Basanti. So each year, each film I did was a different look. So she's getting confused.
I remember you.
She doesn't know what is me, the real me anymore. Abhi aage ka jo main film mein sign kar raha hu, uske baare mein maine koi decision liya nahi abhi tak puri tarah se.
Your favorite director, as you mentioned.
Yeah, yeah, Mr. Raja Mauli, yeah, he's a wonderful director.
He's your favorite also.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you're working with him. We are not sure on that. Like there was an...
That must be a rumor. I mean, I would love to work with him. I think he's a wonderful director. And if I get the chance to work with him, I would love to work with him.
Yeah. Sir, he is doing Mahabharat. He is doing Mahabharat. So, in Mahabharat, which character do you want to...
Oh, he's doing Mahabharat?
Yes.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. In Mahabharat, you know, if I was to act in Mahabharat, there are two characters who I really love. One is Karna.
Okay.
And the other is Krishna. So I would probably end up playing Krishna.
Okay.
If the person making the film feels I'm appropriate. Because Karna is a warrior, you know. I don't see myself as a warrior. 6 feet, 6 inches, you know. He's born with Kavach and Kundal. So I'm not sure I can visually portray that. Physically, I can portray that. Or no, I don't know. So perhaps I'm more suited for Krishna. See, I have to say that each and every personality in Mahabharata is wonderfully etched. So as an actor, you can do negative role or positive role. That is not so important. I think bringing out the character that you are supposed to portray in its honesty, and people should feel that you are that character, is more important. Mahabharata is a wonderful, it's a really amazing piece of, you know, it's one of the proudest things that we are in India about is the Mahabharata. And that is something I would love to be a part of. बहुत सारे लोग बोलते हैं कि बेटी उतनी ही अहमियत रखती है जितना बेटा, लेकिन वो एक इंसान है जिन्होंने वो करके दिखाया. And he has always believed in that. So he is a very big hero for me. And the challenge that Geeta and Babita had in front of them, and the hard work they put in, the level of passion and the achievement they have you know, reached, is quite rare. I think ek Hindustan ke chote se gaon se wo ladkiyan aati hain aur wo pure vishwa pe apna chhap chhod jati hain. It's not a small thing.
And what is your take on demonetization?
You know, I feel that it's something that we should support. It's something that our government is trying to do, which is meant for improving the situation that we have in the country. And certainly any attempt to do that, we must all support. There may be difficulties along the way, but in the long run, I think we should look at the long run.
Thank you.